This is going to be a very quick tutorial on how to make home recordings. Here is our 2-minute Edison reproducer. Here is our 2-minute Edison recorder. The sapphires on these are very delicate and you must never set them down on a table or a hard surface, otherwise you will break the sapphire. And the last thing that we need is a shaved wax cylinder right there. You want to make sure it's got good shine to it. And now we're going to move on to the machine. First thing we want to make sure of is that our machine is in 2-minute mode. Most of these machines are 2-minute only. This particular one has a 2- and 4-minute kit. So I'm going to push the button and make sure that it is, in fact, in 2-minute mode. Put on our record. And then carefully, we're going to insert our recorder into the carriage. Okay. Now, one thing that I always like to check from the side, you want to make sure that that disc, when you lower the recorder onto the record, that it doesn't bottom out. Some of the blank cylinders out there are really, really thick. And if this disc goes all the way up like that, it's going to bottom out and it's going to break your recorder. So you want to make sure that it has a little bit of room to float like this one does. Our next order of business is to hook up a recording horn. You can use the 14-inch horn with these, but you're going to get, you know, a pretty decent recording and playback out of that. But me, myself, I like to use a 25-inch recording horn. So I'm going to hook our horn up right there. And then we're going to bring our recorder to the beginning of our blank. I already wound this up, so it's got plenty of power in it. And then the next thing we do, you can either put the recorder down and let the machine speed up, or let the machine speed up, then lower the recorder. So I'm going to record my voice. Here we go. Hi there. I'm speaking into the recording horn with a slightly elevated voice, and by doing so, I'm allowing my voice to be recorded onto a wax cylinder. If you lower your voice to a conversational strength, it doesn't usually pick up all of your sibilants and vowels and all of your mouth noise. So I'm going to raise my voice a little bit, and notice I didn't say Mary had a little lamb. And that's our recording. We're going to shut off the machine, and now we're going to remove our recorder, set that down. Okay, see you have a lot of cutting swarf there on the top. And remove our blank. And there's gonna be a lot of cutting shavings on there. I'm just gonna blow it off and then inspect under the light. There are our modulations, okay? So we're gonna put that back into the machine and put our playback reproducer on there and connect our horn. And let's see what we get.
Hi there. I'm speaking into the recording horn with a slightly elevated voice. And by doing so, I'm allowing my voice to be recorded onto a wax cylinder. If you lower your voice to a conversational strength, it doesn't usually pick up all of your sibilants and vowels and all of your mouth noise. So I'm going to raise my voice a little bit. And notice I didn't say Mary had a little lamb. And
that's our recording. Wow. There we are. So another thing of note here, and I'm going to write this down, is that the diameter of your cylinder, the width from here to here, it can be no more than 2.171 inches in diameter, okay? If the cylinder is too big, it's going to bottom out. So we have my little caliper tool here. This particular one is 2.145, and that's fine. So there you are. If you have any questions, please contact me. I think I did a pretty quick and straightforward segment here. If you need your cylinders shaved, you're going to have to either send them back to whoever you got them from to have them shaved, or if you have a shaving machine or shaving attachment for your machine, that is another option, but I've never had great luck with the original attachments for these machines. So there you are. I hope that helps.